Hey LHS, I'm supposed to be hosting today, but I have more important things to be doing. Besides, there's just too much to talk about. The juniors take on the seniors, we fight communism, and we talk about too many sports. I can't do it. Take it away, Lauren.
Scrubbing the floor for a party. Aren't you tired of doing all that back-breaking work? Well, I have this brand new product here that will make your medical bills just a wee bit lighter.
The flop mop. It's the newest back-breaking breakthrough in house cleaning utensils. It's great for defense.
For Mother Russia!
Meh.
Hello everybody, my name is Vladimir Muppetin, and I am here to present to you this brand new product. Watch, is it?
Are you sick of communism? The flop mop is great, withholding America's strongholding views of democracy.
War, Russia!
For this special time offer, we'll throw in just the flop.
Yeah.
Oof.
And it's great for defeating your enemies.
America.
And it's also very good for cleaning up the mess of two boring infomercialists.
Ba-da-ba.
Oh great, you're back. Was this mop not enough for you, huh?
Hey, I'm Gabby.
I'm Michael.
And we're from the Letterman's Club.
Yep, and so there's a really exciting dance coming up on December 15th after the boys' home basketball game against Hobart. It's after the basketball game in the cafeteria until whenever the game, or from when the game ends after until around 10:30, and it's going to be themed ugly Christmas sweaters. So it's not going to be like it's going to be more casual dance, not like a dress up like formal one. But there's also going to be like a DJ. And there's going to be everything normal. It's just going to be like you're going to wear an ugly Christmas sweater. So it'll be pretty cool.
Yeah, and this is the first year the Letterman's Club is doing this. It's actually, we're doing it as an Angel Tree fundraiser. So we're really hoping to make it successful and raise a lot of money. The more people that show up, the more families we can help. Admission is going to be only $5, but if you bring in a donation of essentials such as a packet of socks, gloves, underwear, you can get into the dance for free. So you can go to the game, enjoy, have a good time at the game, and then come over to the dance and help for a good cause. Thank you.
We've highlighted teachers here at Lowell High School, so let's see what kind of students we got when Kish and Derek go in-depth with one of our students.
Hello, I'm your host, Derek Govert. Today we're going in-depth with one of our very own students, Trent Maces. Good afternoon, Trent. So, are the rumors true? Can you not talk?
Of course I can talk. I just choose not to.
I see. A lot of students find you strange, Trent. With you not talking and having some original methods of going about your day, some people go as far as labeling you as weird or a freak. Would you agree with that?
Stop looking at me, you freak.
To gym. Yay.
I can't think of anything out of the ordinary.
Interesting. So tell me, Trent, we see how you are at school. What about at home?
What about it?
Like, how do you start your day?
Perfect.
Time for school.
just like any other teenage kid would.
I assume so. So Trent, what are some of your hobbies?
I like basketball.
I should have seen that one coming. One thing many people know about you is that you're always at Evergreen Park. Playing basketball at the park means you play against many different people. Have you picked up a specific type of play?
I guess you could say I use unconventional methods.
You really like basketball. So Trent, you don't have a daylight forever. What do you do when you can't go outside?
Well, when I'm at home, I play video games.
What type of games?
NBA 2K games.
Oh, so you love basketball video games as well?
Not just that, it's a very well-made game.
It's a 5-point game. Oh, that's a joke! Wide open! Okay, I'm done.
Helps me remove my stress that I have throughout my day of school.
Wow, I feel like I've learned a lot about you, Trent. Thank you for stopping by on our student spotlight.
Bye.
We do all love Trent, that goofy boy. Well, we do have some interesting kids here at Lowell High School. We should do that more often. As much as I do hate hosting, I like giving back. So let's see what Miss Chichen's got going on for the blood drive.
Hi LHS, it's Miss Chichen. I'm calling you guys to come help us honor Jake Bergonia this year with our blood drive. One pint of blood can help save 3 lives, so let's honor him with his life and giving life. So this year on December 6th, we're having our fall blood drive, and this year it's run a little bit differently. Everything is gonna be digital. So you can go on, and on all these signs, it has the website that you need to go to, and then it has our high school sponsor code. When you go there, you need to create an account. And then once you've created an account, you can go ahead and pick up any of the time slots that are open on the main sign-up sheet. If you guys have any questions, feel free to come find me or look at the student announcements, and there'll be more details. Thanks.
All right, make sure you get your Bergonia stickers, and don't forget to give blood.
Tickets are on sale now for Shakespeare Fest. Tickets are only $1. The show is next Thursday and Friday during all class periods, except for 3rd hour and 7th hour because of lunch. Again, tickets are only $1. Purchase yours today.
Well, I can't run away from my problems, but I know people that can run pretty far, so let's get into cross country.
Hey, RDN, and welcome to the Sports Report, where we're going to be reporting all about cross country. I'm Jesse Muskell.
And I'm Alec Fleming. In this sports report, we're going to go study a topic we have no clue about. We're going to go ask people questions about cross country, and then we're going to take those questions and ask actual cross country runners and see what we can learn and what you can learn. Let's go out to the streets and see what it's like. How long do cross country runners race?
5.3.
It was at least like 10 miles the most,
I think. Isn't it like 3? Is it a 5K?
I'm not sure. It just depends, I guess, how fast they run.
5 miles. Let's go 5 miles.
Okay, so how did the cross country team do this season?
Pretty good, I think.
They went to state, they ran fast at state, too.
You guys know what they placed at state?
Third.
First place.
I'm going to say...
Doubles.
No idea.
Did you just try to guess?
32.
It's Lowell. So I'm going to say that they got at least third.
What's an average finishing time for a cross-country runner?
Like 18 minutes, maybe? No, I'd say like 16.
13 minutes.
Yeah, that's what 15. I was going to say, 13.
I'm more in like the 17, 18 range.
Like I said, if you're good, maybe 15 minutes.
Oh, 10 minutes.
Probably 7 seconds.
How long do cross-country runners run?
3 hours, 4 hours?
7 miles.
Too much.
Pretty sure it's in like the 10 mile range. I know you guys usually do a pretty good run.
Far.
Like, no clue.
Like 3 hours.
So football has different classes. Do you know what class that cross country's in?
2A.
I don't think it's split up in divisions. I think it's all everyone runs. Everyone's in the same, you know, equal.
Yeah.
Level.
Equality.
3 or 4A.
I'm assuming 4A.
Let's go with 3B.
Can you name any of, like, the top runners?
Jordan Boyer.
Jordan and Jesse.
Boyer. Probably, like, Jordan Boyer.
Jordan.
One kid, he's, like, a sophomore. No, he's a junior. He drives, like, red truck.
Red truck guy.
Red truck.
He's Jordan Boyer. Whoa.
So, Jordan, are you the only person on the team?
No, there's like 30 girls on our team.
Oh, okay.
What's it like running a 10-mile race?
I've never ran a 10-mile race in my life.
So how long is it?
Oh, it's a 5K, so it's about 3.1.
Football was in class 4A, obviously. So we heard that you guys are in class 3B. Is that a hard class to be in?
So you'd consider yourself an average cross-country runner, correct?
Yeah.
I'm probably average.
Okay, so would your time be comparable to the average time of about 10:25?
A little bit slower than that.
Like how much slower?
Probably about 6 minutes.
Okay, so he sucks. Points. You score a lot of points for your team, right?
I mean, no, actually, because in cross-country, it's the lowest points win, so like... I score pretty much lower points. So.
This is all interesting stuff.
So we heard you guys had a great season and you guys got first at state. That's actually like insane. Like how was that?
We got, I think, 11th place at state, but we got first at a lot of our other meets throughout the year.
Okay, kind of disappointing.
Is it true that when you guys are training, you train for about, you run for 3 hours straight around the track, right?
That would suck. No, we don't at all. Maybe like a max run would be an hour.
And like, where do you guys run though?
Around town.
Interesting. So looking at your shoes, you know, I'm looking at these right here. Let me just take a quick little look. You got this one, this one. They're not the same. So what's it like? So those are Nikes. What's it like running an Air Max?
I've actually never tested it out.
I'm just going for style.
Those are just style.
Yeah.
Okay. So you run in those, correct?
No.
Oh, so he doesn't run in Nikes either. Interesting. Do you know who the red truck guy is?
What? No.
Nobody knows who this guy is. Hi, my name is Alec Fleming. I score a lot of points, 157 of them. I'm like the best scorer on the team. You know, I'm out here getting 150. Name another kid on the state who's getting 157 points. Nobody, because only one person can score that many points. Me. You know what I'm saying?
Good job, cross country. Well, our football team did go to state this year and had an undefeated regular season, so good job, boys. All right, with those fall sports out of the way, let's not forget, swim season's coming up, so watch out for them. McClendon really wants me to plug the yearbook, so if you haven't bought one, buy one.
Hey, Gage, I need your help with something.
Yeah, I'll be right there. Just one second, really quick. All right. All right. Yeah, I bet. So for the holidays, the yearbook is going to be a great decision. I'll be right there. Just one second. Not happening. So let's see if the juniors can finally earn their pride back from the seniors, or maybe not.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to RDN's first family feud. I'm your host, Seneca Shutter. We're the juniors up against the seniors. Let's go meet them. What's your name?
I'm Haley Jenkins.
Okay.
I'm.
What's your name?
I'm Brandon Chocho.
Okay. What's your name?
Caitlin Dutro.
Okay. That's a panel of juniors. Let's go over to the seniors. What's your name?
Jason Minkowski.
Johnson. Bradley Johnson.
All right. Congratulations. Wow. I'm sorry. What's your name?
Warren Kaiser.
Okay. We're going to go through some of the little, like, the rules and how this works, okay? So, one member from each team is going to come up here. I'm going to ask them a question, okay? You both are going to ring the bell. Whoever rings it first and gets the answer correct, they will get the point, and they'll choose to either play it or give it to the other team. If you get three incorrect out of the questions I ask you, it goes to the other team. The other team gets that one question correct, they get the points. Okay, all right, enough of that useless stuff. Let's get the first question. Jake, Haley, come on. Okay. All right. We have 100 students at Lowell High School. Name one thing that happens at school days.
Grinding.
You're a sicko. It's true. Grinding! Would you like to play?
We're going to play.
Maybe next time. What's your name again?
Johnson. Brother Johnson.
Johnson. Okay. Well, we've asked 100 students in Lowell High School. Name one thing that you would do at school games.
Sweat.
Good answer. Yeah.
Woo!
You hug the pan, I like it.
Sweating!
Come on!
Nice try, you do it next time.
Oh, this is sick. Boy. Please tell me one thing, you get 2 days.
Socialize.
So, you're one of those, you're in the back, I understand.
I don't know how to dance.
Okay. Socializing!
Hi, Jake, you got the question right at the beginning. See if you can do it again. Name one thing that made you a whole high school dance.
Play bad music.
Oh.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
What else do you do?
Play bad music!
I love making.
I'm sorry. It's okay.
They have a chance to steal. See if they can take it.
Okay, Haley. You've asked 100 Lowell High School students. What's one thing you need to dance?
Throw the water fountain.
Just get him out of here.
Incorrect! Go to the water fountain!
Oh! We got the points!
Really?
The seniors take the points?
No. Yeah!
The juniors are not getting it. Correct. On to the next question. We get the next people off from the juniors and seniors. We have him. We have Chocho. Come on up. Woo! Get pumped!
Alright. Okay. Lowell High School has so many upcoming artists. We asked LHS, who is the most known?
Drum beat,
ready?
Hey.
Young B!
And seniors get
can
up
you
yet.
Play?
Yes, you can play.
Okay.
Woo! Hey. Look, juniors might be louder, but seniors always get the points.
Wow.
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 But I think she's like dead now, right?
Boy.
Just say cheese.
Lowell High School has so many upcoming artists. We asked at HS, who's the most known?
J-Space.
I think it's going to be
he graduated. Nice guy. J-Space!
I'm not
playing this game anymore. Jake, Lowell High School has so many upcoming artists. You got to name one of them. Which one's the most known?
Cedric, he dances. I'm gonna go with my personal good friends, Brandon King and Javier Gana of Came Out Swinging.
Came Out Swinging?
Yeah.
They did a nice town show, I think, a couple years ago. I remember that.
Yeah.
Came Out Swinging! Seniors, you guys are
right.
Okay. See, last try. Get this one incorrect. Goes over to the juniors and they can take the points. Okay? The most known artist of all high school.
No, you can't do that.
Little
Sir. No.
Little Sir. You know who that is?
Bradley.
Little Sir is Noah. Little Sir.
Woo!
Okay,
well, I don't know what it is.
Now we won.
Congratulations. You actually got a point correct. I'm proud of you.
Literally.
Go on. Get another chance.
Okay, well.
Most known artist of all high school.
I don't know. No one.
You gotta name somebody.
Cedric.
Cedric Cachetta.
I can't see, he's a little familiar with that. Cedric Cachetta!
What?
What?
I got
one right!
He dances.
Yes!
Isn't it one?
Yeah.
Jake, you got one more choice. You guys hit incorrect. The juniors had the chance to take it, take all the points.
Well, we've gotten 3 right, so there's nothing we went by.
Okay. Yes, we're talking over.
All right, let's go.
You both need a little huddle, because they get it incorrect. You never know. All right, okay. Okay, here we go. Last time, here we go. Lowell High School, so many upcoming others. Others. Name one.
Casey Cox.
What?
She's a legend. Casey Cox! Incorrect.
Damn.
Hey, the juniors had the chance to steal it.
You won't do it.
Name one.
Oh my god.
He's wrong in the show.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Do I have to sing? Oh my god. Who is it? Rico Suave.
Rico Suave! And again, seniors take the points, you got it incorrect.
Yeah,
no. On to the third question.
Yeah, this is rigged.
Kate and Lauren.
Here we go. Ask you a question. Okay, now, I'm not saying you guys are bad kids, but in the event you do get pulled over, what is one thing not to do? Juniors, what are you guys doing?
Drive away?
Yes.
You know what?
Drive away! Look, you guys like to,
is that right?
You guys like to be nice to the juniors? You guys gonna take
the scene?
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Right.
He knows his rights.
Jake knows his rights.
Just hey, you guys never know. You get 5 points.
This one has six.
Here we go. Six top answers. Here we go. Now, same format. I say you get pulled over. What's one thing you do not do?
Yell at the officer.
Good answer.
Yell at the officer! Not good enough.
You do a guy. What kind of ball?
You just play football.
Me. Back my younger years before I got young. Bit mustache and a stomach, but. Alright, anyway. Let's say you do get pulled over. Maybe you have, probably. What's one thing you don't do?
Act suspicious.
Access for in which we get it, clarify yourself.
Don't withdraw a gun on the officer.
I took a turn. Withdraw a gun!
Ding!
What are you doing? Wow. Okay. Okay, let's say you get pulled over. Okay. What's one thing you don't do?
Hurt the officer.
Like fight the officer? What do you mean by
hurt assault? Them in any way? Assault.
Yeah, it's called jail time. Yeah. Assaulting the officer.
Right. Jake, it's coming down here.
One more. Julius, look, one more. Then you guys have a chance. Think it over.
I just want 1 point.
1 point. You don't have to. 5 points is the, you know, what you need.
Why don't I get you so far?
Okay.
Don't test me. Alright.
He does this shit though.
Alright, Jake, you're doing pretty good. Alright, now let's say you get pulled over. Okay. Speeding, okay. Swerving, anything. No seatbelt effects. What's one thing you don't do?
You probably shouldn't compliment the officer's eyes. Tell the truth. Yeah, never tell the truth because you can incriminate yourself. That's your Fifth Amendment.
Yeah. So which one's the answer?
Don't incriminate yourself.
Don't tell the truth.
Don't tell the truth.
Okay.
Right. Don't tell the truth.
So it goes from complimenting an officer's eyes to lying. Okay.
Exactly.
Don't tell the truth! I actually saw that one coming. I don't know why. Alright, look. Juniors, I'll give you 10 seconds to get this over.
Okay,
and I'm going to Brandon. He's the second person. You guys get some 5 points at this one.
I think you won
my
other.
Maybe. Probably good.
Just right here. Boom.
Juniors might have been louder.
No, so no. All
right, here we go. Brandon, let's say you do the world. One thing you do not.
Well, you really don't want to hurt the officer's feelings. I mean, you just want to be really nice.
Hey, no, it's a good answer. I'm okay with that. Would it be nice to the officer? Being nice and polite! Woo!
Well, counts of courtesy.
Juniors.
What?
You suck.
Okay.
It says, what do you not?
Juniors.
Exactly. I said, don't talk back.
Junior,
What's that one?
Okay,
what?
The answers were. Asking for a lighter! Asking him for his license registration. Look, you guys just could have thought, you know, what happens if you pull over?
Please.
I'm very disappointed in you.
I'm
disappointed
too.
Anyways, oh, God. Okay. Okay.
Oh.
Alright. Look, next pepper, we'll find out who actually wins again.
The seniors win every year.
Hey, look, I'm just a TV host, okay?
Okay.
I'm not even
alone,
man.
Yeah.
Alright, wrap it up.
Alright. Okay, that concludes the first RDN Family Feud. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for being our contestants. Seniors won. I swear to God, I always win. Have a great night.
Well, juniors, we lost a spirit stick. We've lost the game show. Looks like we've lost all of our pride, but I guess we got it next year. Well, this is finally over, so thank you. I have so much work to get to. Well, I guess we'll catch you next time for the holiday special hosted by Santa Claus himself. So I'll catch you then.